And here we finally have it. I think it turned out nice. Hey guys, Clumsy here, and welcome back to Modded ARK. In the past two episodes, we were focusing on building the castle walls, and we finally managed it. So we finished the outer castle walls, but in this episode, I want to make the inside, the actual castle keep. So I actually did a bit of work already. You can see these platforms here. These are nothing but shelters for our dinos. So they have, so they're protected from the sun. Just a bit of roleplay in there. It doesn't really serve any purpose other than that for now. But inside, I also made some changes. You can see the walls here now. So we have these outer castle walls, which we finished the last two episodes. And we have the inside now. So this is just enclosed wall right there. And this border right here would act as the actual castle keep. Now, I'm not sure how that would look. I have a rough idea, but we'll have to go from there. So there will be a bit of trial and error, a bit of redesigning that will happen, but we'll see how it goes, right? So I'll go and get some more materials because I am lacking some essential items, but I'll be right back and we'll start building. Okay, let's do this. So we do have these four borders in here. I want these four borders to stand for our corner towers. So just like how we have towers on our outer walls for each corner, those are rounded though, but in this case, I want actually a square or a straight tower for each of the corners of the keep. So we'll keep that as towers, but in here, I think I want to make... Actually, I'll have to enclose them off first. If I would want to be successful in imagining how that should look like. Now that these are all enclosed, let's see from above one quick look. Yep, all of them are enclosed. Now I did that because the next step is to place the walls in the middle. And I want the walls to actually be something in here, like in here. But the trick here is we cannot put them on this side. It might be hard to see, but we can't put them on the side here. Ah, yeah, there's this line, right? We can't put them to the left of that, like this. We have to put them inside, like that. Otherwise, we'll have trouble later on with putting the ceilings because the ceilings only snap to the inside of the cell, and if we put the wall here, the ceiling will snap only on this side, on the outside here, not on the inside of the castle keep. I'm not sure if that makes sense, but I'll show you that later once we get to the ceiling part, right? For now, just trust me on this. So let me just enclose this, and then the next step is to put some steps, some stairs. So we do have this mega gate. So when we're coming from outside, we have this mega drawbridge. We're going inside, we're going through this mega gate, and after a few steps in here, we arrive at the keep. Now I would want some kind of stairs here. So let's go and put some. Just two would be okay. And I put these half castle walls, just so it won't look too out of proportion with the steps. I think that adds a nice touch. That should be okay. Alright. Something like that. Okay. And then let's put in the mega gateway. No, this is not the mega gateway. The mega gateway is like that. This is the massive gateway. It's also large, but not as large as we would first imagine. Okay. Now, can you put yourself like... not like that, but horizontal, please. Like that, I think. Yes. Is that the center? Yes, it is. Alright. Good thing you're cooperating now. And let's just close that off with a gate. Like so. Perfect. Yes. Exactly how I want it. Now, from there, we just enclose this with normal walls. And I'll keep doing that till we have everything enclosed. Alright? So once we have that enclosed, actually the other side here, we would also need to fill with half walls. And same here, the line, it cannot be on the outside in here. It has to be inside the keep, so we can place the ceilings better. Like right there. Alright guys, I'll be right back. Okay. Even though it's raining and the weather totally isn't cooperative, we will make this work, guys. So I think it's coming to shape now. Not much, but it's a start, right? So I'll go and fill this up. Next step is, after it finishes hanging, right there, we should put in some ceilings, which I do not have. Actually, I do. Right here. Yes. Perfect. So we just have to fill this up in there. Alright. Now this is what I want to illustrate. If we put the walls in here on this side, when we try to snap the ceilings, they will snap on this side here outside the keep instead of inside the keep. Right? So that's a very key concept in this build. If you're trying to build something like this. So now, if we try to plop down these ceilings, they should snap inside, like so. Perfect. Yeah. Okay. Now it's filled. And you might have seen how difficult it was to put some of these ceilings so that they would look perfectly aligned in terms of texture. But we managed it. That's good. So the next step is actually... I'm not sure, honestly. So let's do some trial and error here. I have made some additional items that I haven't tried out before and want to see how it looks like. So if we put something like this, can we put a balcony maybe? A balcony would probably look really nice, but it doesn't seem to snap the way I want it for some reason. If you look from outside, something like this. Ah, it's very small. We can go and put two balconies from either side, I think. But what would that do, right? It would look so small. I don't think that's good. I think I'd rather put battlements there. Yeah, just like how we do have them for these walls in here. Yeah, I'll try that out, guys. Be right back. Okay, there. Now we have battlements on the walls. Looks very cool. Looks very castle-ish. I'm not so sure about the towers, though. I'm not sure if I want it at this height or at this height. And I'm also not sure if it can stay in this... one by one dimension, because I'll show you later on. But first, I want to build something here as well. So this looks pretty cool and all, but it looks kind of plain actually if you look here at the top. So I want to put maybe a second level here, and I'm thinking we could do that by getting the center in here and putting something here. Only problem is, it would be very hard to see now because the ceiling textures are so synchronized, so seamless. It's so hard to see which cell we're at. So it's hard to measure, like in here, in the floor, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, you can count easily because of the lines. The ceilings don't have that, they're just like one massive block. So what they thought is we could make some floors. These are like things you put on top of foundations or ceilings to change their texture. And this would also help in determining which floor we're at. So actually, let me fly again. It would be harder from below. It would be nicer to have a bird's eye view on this. So this is the center. The center two tiles. I want to build something here. So this is one. This is two. Actually, I want to put something there. here, here, and here. So something like this. So we can build like a second tower out of that, maybe. Or maybe it needs to be one wider. Otherwise, it would be too small. Yeah. So let's make it one wider. It won't be square, but that should be okay. Something like that should be good. Yes. So if we look from here. Yeah, not bad. And then we'll just raise this. So now we know the exact dimensions of our tower. Then we can just build walls inside that. Make sure that the walls are inside the tiles. Yep, exactly like so. Perfect. And I also want to try something. So this is the center, right? Where is the center? 1, 2, right. I have something here, which I'm not sure if it will work. Ah, it's not too... Oh, it is big. It is humongous, actually. So I can go ahead and build something like this. Amazing. This is amazing, guys. Look at that. From here, it does look kind of a... It makes it look like a church, kind of, because of the stained glass, but I think I'll keep it. Looks pretty cool. And adds a bit of accent, even though it hanged a bit. Adds a bit of accent to our castle keep. Randomize pieces, what does that mean? So if we, like, randomize. Ah, okay, so you can change the design. Cool. That's nice. How about cycle solid colors? Ah, okay. So you can have them one color, or if you want a more random feel, just randomize them like that. That looks really awesome. So we can actually have a single color, just so it won't be too cathedral-ish looking. Maybe something blue. Yeah. And that would be more, yeah, like this. This is a bit purple, I think. Like that would be nice. Just like a normal glass. Oh, this is see-through. I think I would want a bit of a tint, actually. But I'll see how that goes. And I'll enclose this whole area with walls. And I'll be right back. Yep, that should be okay. That should be okay right there. Now, we don't have any entrance so far. Might need to do something here on the side. Or in front. In front, we can't do it because we have that stained glass thing. But we can put in some stuff on the side. Right here, maybe. Behind here. But I'll worry about that later on. We're focusing on the exterior anyway. And I can just demolish things afterwards. Now this also helps me decide. Because if we have only this height of a tower, then it's too small for this. The tower has to be the tallest thing, I think. So it should be like this. Yeah, that works. So I'll go and fill this up with ceilings again. And we'll see how this goes. Do I want a roof here? Or do I want like battlements? Not yet sure. Okay, let's do a bit of an experiment, alright? Now, the battlements look pretty nice and all. It adds very much to the castle theme. But I also want to try something out. So maybe if we can try this a roof, if that would look nice. That would be awesome. But keep an open mind. And let's see how this should go. Alright. Like that. Yes. And also here. So if we can put something like that. And then put in a wall. Or actually a roof. In here. How does this work? Alright. Let's put something like this maybe. Yeah. And this should blend right there. Yeah, these are like modular roofs that are compatible. And we do have like a center, right, and left. So this should be the right one, I guess. Like that. Perfect. Yes. And this one should be the left part. Yeah. And it combines perfectly like so. And also gets enclosed like that. It looks like a proper house. I'm just not sure if it looked like a proper castle now, since we have it like that, but we'll see. So let me just continue here. And that, and then one more here. Actually, this should be the left side, I think. Yeah. And this should be the right side. Alright, there we go. Now, how does that look for our castle key? I'm not really sure. It would have been safer to just put the battlements. This likes, I put the house on top of the castle. So I'm quite conflicted with how all of this looks, but maybe we'll keep it for now just to add a bit of touch. And I'll also put some, for the towers, I'll also put some roofs in it. The only problem here is with these towers, they're too small for the normal roofs. So let me show you. If I want to put roofs here, and I put it like this, let's make it on the other side. If I want to make it like this, there, you see, it's too small. So I'll have to extend this one more, make it a 2x2 instead of a 1x1. I think that should be how it works. Yeah. And the angle of the roofs are different from here versus that one. So I might have to flip this as well. Make it something like this. To make it consistent. I'll see what I can do, guys. And I'll... Oh. And our guy just left us. Perfect. Alright, guys. Be right back. Okay. So I decided to change my mind again. The roofs are nice and all, but they're not castle-ish. So I might use the roofs on a different structure, but I want to keep the castle feel of this as much as I can. So remove the roofs, put in some ceilings, and instead what I'm trying to do is add the third level. So we have the first level here with the gateway, the second level with the stained, this humongous glass, stained glass, and the third one would be a round tower, I think. Not sure how that would look, but we will try. Let me see. As soon as I can go through. There. So this is the center. This is the center here. If I put something like... now this is the trouble here. How do I place you correctly? Yeah, this is hard because we don't have the rounded foundation, but there it goes. That's the one. I think. Yeah. Just make sure that I don't trap myself inside. That would be problematic. Uh-huh. I might have to go here and do this. Because it's easier to snap from inside. Yeah, that's the way. So if I look here, that doesn't look too bad, I think. So we can enclose that with windows all throughout. Now, as I mentioned, we're working on the exteriors here only, so I don't have a way to go inside that. At least not yet. But we will have it eventually, alright? So if I... Excuse me? If I go through here, 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 and here, that should be enough. Two levels would be more than enough. Yeah, from outside, it looks like a... do I like it? Do I like those windows there? From the side, how does it look? Doesn't look too bad. I think it's okay. But this will be even better once we put in the battlements. So let me put that in as well. Anyway, I'll work on that, guys, and I'll bring you guys back when it's ready to show. Right? There we go. Much better, I think. Yeah, so battlements all throughout, and I changed these, remove the windows. I think it's much better without the windows there, because the stained glass puts in all the accent we need. Anything else would be too much already. Yes. And then let's just put the battlements in here. It would be easier to put the battlements from inside and from below. I think that's how the developer made that. Just enclose that everything. And then put in a gateway. I want to try this out. Like that. And put in the hatch. Actually, this is a gate that's rotating. So it'd be perfect for flyers. So I can go here, open that from here, and go inside. Perfect, right? This is the perfect house for flyers. Very cool. Only thing is that it doesn't have sound. Oh, it does. It actually does. Cool. Alright, so that's how it looks now. And I'm not sure how else we can make it prettier. But I think for now, that's good. Only thing left are the towers. And for the towers, I think it should be pretty much set. I'll try and work on that, and I'll be right back. Height would probably be something like this. So the tallest building would be this one, which is perfect. Because this would be like a lookout from the king's point of view. You can see everything, your whole kingdom. Your whole castle, at least. And then the towers would be high as well, but not as high. Yep, sounds good. And here we finally have it. I think it turned out nice. So for the towers, it just remains as one by one. I just put some windows here. And some battlements on top with ceilings enclosing it. Right? Pretty simple, but the effect is definitely there. Towers, they are. And if we look from this angle, I think it looks really nice. Only thing is, it's all exterior, as I mentioned. So if we go inside here, if we go inside, actually, it'll just fall right through. All right through there. So yeah, there's still a lot of work to be done, but and I got stuck for some reason. I think it's because of this wall. Yeah, look, I'm skidding here now. Oh yeah, definitely something needs to be done here. Okay, there, I was able to get out of it. But yes, that will be sometime in the future, but probably not in the next episode, because I'm very happy with how this turned out. Let me know, guys, what you think about this. But so far, I think it is great for our castle build. And the main reason why I wanted this kind of setup here, is so I have all the space I need to capture, to tame all the dinos I want. So we can have like a dino collection and I can just park them over here at the side. Yeah, all the space here. So even the largest dino should fit perfectly. And then we have a castle which is more or less ornamental right now, but eventually maybe we'll get something to add it to it, make it functional, put some things inside like treasures, vaults, workshops and everything. But in the meantime, I'm very happy how it turned out, and I can make this my base, this small part here, just for the workshop thing. Maybe I'll make something simple. But yes, guys, I think that's gonna be it for this episode, and I'm glad we were able to do something. It looks majestic from this angle. The symmetry. OCD at my OCD is not complaining at all. Anyway, guys, let me know what you think in the comments. If you did like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more updates. In the meantime, this is the Clumsy Geek signing off. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye, guys. There we go. Bye-bye. See you soon.